Hey, if you're an agency building websites for clients, or you're part of an in-house team building your own software, collecting feedback on live website can be a struggle. In this tutorial, I'm going to walk you through the steps to help you set up your account properly. Let's get started. In Marker.io, everything starts with a destination. Think of a destination as an existing project that lives in your tools that you connect to Marker.io. To add your first destination, first select the tool in which your existing project lives. Marker.io supports all types of tools like Jira, Asana, GitHub, GitLab, and more. In this video, we'll use Trello as an example. Simply connect your integration and allow access to your account. This permission will allow Marker.io to create issues in your project management system on your behalf. Once you've granted access, you can view all existing projects. Let's assume that we've been working on a project called Awesome Client Website. Simply find the Trello board for which the project was created, specify the website on which you want to collect feedback from, and hit the big button. Congratulations, you've created your first destination. Now it's time to collect some feedback and invite people. Inside your destination account, you can invite both members and clients in the user list. By default, all team members have access. However, clients do not and need to be added manually for better control. Since the onboarding process for members and clients is pretty similar, we'll invite a client together and see how it works. Choose in which Trello list inside your board you want your client's feedback to land in, and enter the email address. They will soon receive an email inviting them to start reporting feedback on the website you listed. The email will direct them to the feedback dashboard. As a client, since I haven't reported any feedback yet, I'm encouraged to jump to my project website and start reporting some feedback. As soon as I land on the website, I'm asked to install Marker.io's browser extension. Keep in mind, this is a one-time job and it literally takes 3 clicks. 1, 2, 3. The extension is now installed, and we get a message telling us to use the extension as soon as we find something worth reporting. From the get-go, the client notices that his logo is missing. The client will use Marker.io's browser extension to capture a screenshot. Highlight the area where the logo should be added using the built-in annotation tools. And on the right-hand side of the screen, you'll find the sidebar. This is where your reporters will be able to fill out extra information about whatever they're reporting. Because we're working with an external client, we've kept the form pretty simple with only a few fields. But the sidebar can be customized to a lot more than that. We'll see how in a minute. But first, let's report that missing logo before we forget. As soon as I hit the submit button, Marker.io will disappear and do its magic in the background. That way, clients can keep reporting feedback without being interrupted. Now, let's look at the same experience, but from the member's perspective. As a member, I can see that the headline on the website contains a huge typo, so just like my client, I can use the browser extension to capture a screenshot, highlight the typo using the built-in annotation tools. But now when you look to the right, you can see that the sidebar reveals a lot more fields. This is because as an internal team member, you need the flexibility to report bugs that contain more than a title and a description. The sidebar is at the core of Marker.io's experience, and everything in it is customizable and synchronized. All fields in the sidebar are a reflection of the fields inside your project management tool. In this example, I want to tag my feedback with a typo label, but as you can see, I don't have a typo label just yet. So instead of adding a label in Marker and the same label in Trello, effectively creating two different tools in which to manage my feedback, I will simply go into Trello and do it right there. When I go to my Trello board, I will go to the label settings and create my new typo label there. Now, when I go back to my sidebar, my typo label from Trello is right here. Field synchronization doesn't just work for labels, but also for lists, members, and more. And not just for Trello, but any other project management tool that we support, like Jira, GitHub, Asana, and more. Isn't that powerful? So now when you make a change to your workflow inside your existing tools, you don't have to think about updating it in Marker.io. It just works. As for sidebar customization, you can define which fields in your project management tool you want to show or hide in the Marco.io sidebar. Let's have a look at both sidebars. Let's say I want to hide due dates for members and reveal the label fields for clients. I'll simply head over to my field configuration menu inside the destination, switch off due date for members, and switch on labels for clients. Now, both sidebars updated in real time. One other thing you could do in terms of customization is to update the bug report template inside the description field. Let's head back to the field configuration menu and scroll down. For members, I like to keep it a bit more advanced and always ask them to list the steps needed to reproduce a bug. This can help my developers fix bugs a lot faster down the road. Thankfully, this template is built in by default in Marco.io, so I don't have to change anything. As for clients, since they are usually less technical, I like to create a more conversational template like what is the problem and what is the solution. Once you're happy with the resolve, save and see the sidebars being updated. Okay, now that our reporting sidebars are where we want them to be, let's report that typo bug before we forget. So now we know how a member and a client can report a bug. Now let's see how the developer sees it inside your existing tools. When our developers log into the awesome client website project in Trello, they'll see our bug reports, the client's feedback with the missing logo, and the member's feedback with the typo. Because it was reported through Marco.io, the bug report contains everything your developer would need: the annotated screenshot, the correct label, the right assignee, and most importantly, technical information about the feedback. On which page was this bug reported, which browser and operating system, and more. Now the next question is, how can reporters know when their issues have been resolved? For members, it's pretty simple. Since they are part of your internal team, they can simply go to your project management tool and see how their issue moves from one status to the other. As for clients, there's one big problem though. They don't have access to this tool. So how can they know if their feedback is even being looked at? Glad you asked. If you remember correctly, when we invited clients, we saw that they had access to a feedback dashboard which was empty at the time. Now that our client has submitted some feedback, they can see a record of each issue here. Think of this client dashboard as an external view of the feedback inside your tool. Now, as your team members complete tasks and issues inside your project management tool and move it to the right, they can easily let the client know when something has been fixed, update the client status, and go back to work. Clients will immediately see the status updated in the Marco.io feedback dashboard. And that's in a nutshell how Marco.io works. We now know how to create a destination and link it to a website. We know how to get both internal team members and external clients to report feedback on that website with different experiences based on their technical level. We also know how developers can receive that feedback inside the tool where they are already working, so they don't have to switch back and forth between tools. And we finally know how we can update those clients that have reported feedback to us when something has been resolved. And if you have any other questions, feel free to ask them using the help widget inside the app. Until next time, bye.